In this tutorial, we will configure a system and profile in the Ag Leader DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module. Building systems and profiles is the first step to using the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module. Settings, calibrations, and measurements are saved in the profile to allow the operator to easily switch between applicator configurations without having to re-enter the information every time they switch. The first time the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module is connected to a display, you will see a screen that says the system has not been configured. Tap the green check to begin. We will need to specify whether the machine we are installing on is a sprayer, liquid fertilizer, anhydrous ammonia, or liquid manure applicator. For this example, we will use a sprayer system type. Then we need to select whether this is a towed or self-propelled piece of equipment and specify the location of the boom or toolbar. For this example, we are using a towed implement with a rear mount boom. Tap the next arrow. This screen shows the connected modules and their serial numbers. In addition to the Ag Leader liquid rate control module, you may have additional swath control modules and an implement switch module. Our example machine uses one Ag Leader liquid swath control module. And tap the next arrow. Here we'll need to specify how many sections the sprayer has, including the boom sections and end row nozzles if they are installed. Our example sprayer has three boom sections and one end row nozzle on each side, so we need to enter 5 as the total number of sections. Then from the drop-down under end row nozzles, select both sides. The checkbox at the bottom of the screen determines how we want to control the flow when the end row nozzles are turned on. When this box is checked, the controller will record and map the additional swath width from the nozzle and increase the flow rate accordingly when the end row nozzle is turned on. When the box is not checked and an end row nozzle turns on, no additional area will be recorded or mapped, and the sprayer may underapply across the rest of the boom since the flow rate will not be adjusted. We do want to log flow for the end row nozzles, so we will tap the checkbox. Then tap the next arrow. We need to specify the section valve signal type and valve type. The signal type is what the module will send to turn the section valve on, and more than one signal type can be used if different types of valves are installed on the sprayer boom. The valves on our example sprayer all use a 12-volt signal. Next, select the valve type as either standard or calibrated return. Our example sprayer uses the standard valve type. Tap the next arrow. Review the section overview list and make sure the correct valve type is selected for each boom section. If a section needs to be edited, that can be done by tapping the wrench. For this setup, the overview is correct. Tap the next arrow. This completes the system setup portion, and we will now begin the profile setup. Values entered up to this point will remain the same for all profiles created within this system. An example of using two profiles within a system would be a sprayer that uses only a portion of the total boom sections to do post-emergent applications. To begin, we will need to give the profile a name. For this example, we will name it the make and model of the sprayer. Tap the next arrow. This screen is asking what the nozzle spacing is on the sprayer boom. This sprayer has nozzle spacing of 20 inches. Tap the next arrow. We then need to enter how many nozzles are in each boom section. End row nozzle sections can only contain one nozzle. For the actual boom sections, our example sprayer has 18 nozzles in each section. The number of nozzles in a section may not be equal across all sections for all sprayers. To change the number of nozzles per section, tap the up and down arrow until the section you want to edit is highlighted in blue, then tap the calculator icon to change the number of nozzles. Repeat this as needed so that all boom sections have the correct number of nozzles entered. Tap the next arrow. If there is a Raven Sidekick Pro ISOBUS injection pump on this applicator, this box would need to be checked. For this profile, we don't have an injection pump installed, so we will leave this box unchecked and tap the next arrow. We will need to enter a channel name and container capacity. For this example, we will use the default name and a capacity of 1,000 gallons. Tap the next arrow. On this screen, we will specify the type of rate control valve on the sprayer. This sprayer has a servo rate control valve that controls the product line supplying the boom, so we will select inline servo. Then we need to decide whether we are using a flow meter or pressure sensor for rate feedback. On this sprayer, we have both a pressure sensor and flow meter installed, so we are going to use flow meter for the feedback type, and then check the box to use pressure fallback. Having both a pressure sensor and flow meter allows us to use the hybrid control feature of the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module. Tap the next arrow. If there are auxiliary valves on the applicator, we need to specify whether we want the valve to open or close when all the boom sections shut off. This sprayer does not have any auxiliary valves installed, so we will leave this at the default setting. For the rate control valve behavior, we can select either hold or close. Close will close the valve when all boom sections shut off. Hold will keep the rate control valve in the last position that it was in when the last boom section valve closed, keeping pressure at the boom section valves. For this sprayer, we will choose hold and tap the next arrow. We need to enter the offsets for the sprayer as shown in the picture. To enter a measurement, tap the calculator icon by the appropriate letter you're entering the offset for. Measurement A is the distance from the end of the hitch to the sprayer axle. Measurement B is the distance from the sprayer axle to the application point of the boom. Measurement C is the left and right offset of the boom. If the boom is centered, then C will equal zero. For measurement C, we will also need to specify whether the offset is left or right of center. Once all measurements are entered, tap the next arrow. We have now completed the profile setup. All the sensors will need to be calibrated before use, which will be covered in a separate tutorial. Tap the green check. After creating a new profile, the module needs to restart. Tap the green check to restart the module. As the module restarts, the display will alert you that it has lost communication with the module. Tap the green check to acknowledge this warning. Once the module is finished restarting, it will reload into the Universal Terminal screen. Now you will be able to complete the initial setup in the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid module by building a system and profile. For more information on the setup and operation of this product, please refer to the DirectCommand ISOBUS liquid feature user guide. If you'd like to see more short tutorials from AgLeader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.